are confused about deliverance, prophecy, we don't know. But we are searching for them. We don't know what is prophecy. We don't know what is prophetic message. We don't know what is deliverance. And we are making mistakes, especially all of us who call ourselves Christians. Others say, if I'm born again, I'm a Christian, I don't need deliverance. They tell you that. Me, I'm born in the church. I don't need deliverance. But when we touch you like this, you begin to change, that there is something in you. The moment you touch like this, you find that you begin to scream. We ask, where is this scream come from? If you don't need deliverance. Most of the time, you must know that many people who say they don't want deliverance are the ones who want it. Today, I want to deliver many people here. Amen. I'm not saying this so that you clap hands. I'm saying this even when you're not clapping hands. If you want to see that you need deliverance, look at your character. Look at your lifestyle. Why are you failing on one thing? Why you fail on one thing?
Why you
want to live right, but still,
you
are failing. There's a demon somewhere. Hiding somewhere. Demons, they love to stagnate Christians. A Christian can still shout
hallelujah.
Whereas he's not becoming what God wants him to
be.
What hinders you to be what God wants you to be is
Satan.
So devil doesn't mind, you can live 100 years, 200. As long as you are not the one God has ordained to
you.
So you always live the life of others. If you ever find that the life you are living is not your own life. Let me give an example. Think about if Jesus came to live a life of John the Baptist.
If he
could not be what God wanted him to be. And God could not be glorified. Tell
him,
God will never be glorified if you are living someone's life. How can we live our life? We really need deliverance. Tell everybody, you really need deliverance. You know, I've seen many people who are poor, who are defending their poverty. But deep down, they want to be rich. They were supposed to be fighting what makes them to be poor than to defend their poverty. Because deep down you are inside and outside, you are two different people. If you are excited about your being inside and outside, it means deliverance has taken the place. Because deliverance is there to make you one. Inside and outside. If now you are two, inside you want to be rich, Outside, you don't care about riches. You need deliverance. So, now therefore, deliverance makes you to find yourself. And you'll be satisfied the way you are. How can you compete if you are delivered? Found your life. Tasa was, I want to find my life.
Children.
I found that we are struggling a lot. Concerning our Christian life. Because we sometimes act we are there before we reach there. We are not content. But deliverance can make us that. You reach there. Last time I gave you an example of the difference of prophecy and deliverance. Prophecy and deliverance. I give you an example. As a prophecy will say, you come here and come here and reach here, and therefore this is your destiny. Deliverance doesn't care. It just position you to where you belong. And many people are afraid of deliverance. They are searching for prophecy. Okay, if I reach here,
I'll reach there
and stop here. And that is why many of you are deceived. Because you want to know where you are going. So not where God is taking you. If you know where God is taking you, you don't care about what is happening. Can you see deliverance brings your mind?
Like,
now you believe in scriptures. And the scriptures position you where you believe where you are going, not where you pass to go. So when I look at you, many of you,
I can love when Chibarlina.
You need deliverance.
Arthokolokulo.
Tell me, you need deliverance.
Which I'm too long for Tokolokulo.
Tell me, you need deliverance.
Utokolokulo.
Because deliverance will really point you, you put you there.
Holokulo, what our chia, we are Namola.
When you wake up, you realize, ah,
how to our Lemore.
This is me now.
Ken Najonomo.
I must accept myself.
Kisanchurkete Morel.
Accept yourself. Don't compete, accept yourself. Have you ever find you're competing with someone you don't know how he was born? You're failing to accept yourself. Today I pray that you'll be delivered. I'm pointing at you. I say you'll be delivered. I say you'll be delivered. And I want to tell you why God wants to deliver you. You are failing God. If you are not delivered, you fail God. Because the life you are living here, it's not the life that will glorify your God. You are in a place where God didn't place you. So deliverance will take you where you can represent your God. I want to see you representing him.